Literally, wireless microphone, speaker, a pole, and your computer.
If they can't stop me, even if they stopped me.
What's going on, guys? Yo, it's your boy DJ. We got DJ Unstoppable back with another DJ Giglock behind the scenes. Yo, all right, let me bring the energy down because I'm going to have to break it down for you how I do my ceremony. Hold on. All right, now that the energy is down, let me break it down how I do ceremony. If you've seen my previous videos, oh my goodness, I took all kinds of equipment to a beach ceremony out in the sand. I went through hell. I don't want you to go through that, so that's why I'm gonna break it down for you exactly what I'm using. I minimized everything. That day I took my equipment out to the beach out in the sand. What I'm bringing today is probably 25% of what I brought that day. Come here, let me show you, come here. This is ceremony. Beautiful, beautiful place. I really like this place. Okay, they have a speaker and a facade, but the venue told me I cannot use their speaker. So I'm gonna use my Thump Go. This is a great speaker. I highly recommend it. Yes, there's other speakers in the market which have more power, which are probably a little bit better, but this is ceremony, guys. Keep in mind, it's a ceremony. You don't need 700-800 watts for a ceremony. You really don't. You don't. Have we ever come across a ceremony that requires 700-800 watts? Oh, what's a power? No, you don't. So that's why this is a perfect speaker. Check this out, the Thump Go. It's an 8-inch speaker and it's wireless Bluetooth. Oh, let's turn it off before the battery runs out. This has lasted 14 hours. I used it at two events. One event was 7 hours, the other event was 7 hours. So that's 14 hours together. Also brought the speaker pole from Rockville. This is not your normal speaker pole. As you can see, this is much larger. And this is much smaller because sometimes for ceremony, you are literally in a small space and there's no room for you to flare open the speaker stand. So that's why we have this Rockville speaker stand. But let me show you the highlight of this video. Let me show you where it's at right here. All right, finally, after so many years, so many ceremonies, going through hell, hauling all kinds of equipment, I finally purchased this battery. I'm not gonna break it down the specifics. This is to charge the whole unit. Two plugs so you can connect right here for USB port, I believe for the phone, or what the hell is that for? The car from back in the days for the car. And you also have a light right there. That would be SOS, just in case you're in an emergency. You're killing the dance floor. Bam, that's the light you turn on, SOS. Pretty simple, pretty basic, nothing extraordinary with the handle. It probably weighs like, what, 5-7 pounds? I can plug in my wireless microphone, but no, I'm gonna show you how to do ceremonies much easier. Don't break your back, seriously, don't. Okay, so I'm gonna place this right here. I'm gonna place that right there. I'm using the Phoenix PTU-1U microphone. What I'm gonna do, place it up here. I don't have to place it up there. I don't. I can place it right here. But I'm gonna give you an idea how you can do ceremony without bringing all kinds of equipment. Literally, wireless microphone, speaker, a pole, and your computer. That is literally all you need for ceremony. Let me show you. Also, I brought this double-sided tape just in case somebody, boom, bumps into it and this decides to slide. Just imagine, hey, you never know what you're gonna come across. That's why I've said in my previous videos, be careful where you place your speakers. I don't like to place them across the room, far away from me. I don't like to do that. Because sometimes people are not cautious. Sometimes people will do this, you know, hold on to the speaker and they can knock it down. So that's why I always keep my speakers as close as possible. But watch, let me show you. Hold on. Double-sided tape, you rip it, but of course it's not gonna cooperate because the video's on record, hold on. All right, and we're back. End cutters, just cut it. I know I should have a blade. Of course it's not gonna cut because you're recording. Come on, chingadera, there you go. All right, double-sided tape, pretty simple. You guys know how to use double-sided tape. Of course I can get it. Here, use your fancy nails to get this. All right, finally, even fancy nails over here couldn't get it. Double-sided tape, pretty simple. Just put it right in the middle, in the middle. Bring your wireless, set it up right here, and it's not taping. Oh, there you go. Yeah, it ain't going nowhere. Okay, for audio, Pretty simple, 1/4 inch to XLR. Up there, we're gonna be using the XLR, which is ready, I can't even see. There you go, all right. Then, put it through, run it down, and right in there. That's pretty simple. Now for power. Plug it in. Okay. Bring it down. Yeah, okay. And you connect it in here. Bam, this is power to turn the whole unit on. Do not leave your stuff just like that. You're done? No, you're not done. No. Turn it around, get your zip ties, which we should have. Where are they? No? Okay, pause it real quick, pause it. All right, these I've been carrying for many, many years. How many years? Four. I bought thousands and thousands and thousands of zip ties. Look, they're small. There's others that are pretty large. Look, do me a favor. Go to the 99 cent store, Dollar Tree, or whatever's in your area and purchase these. Buy at least 4 or 5 packs of these, 4 or 5 packs of the big ones. It's gonna make you look so professional, trust me. Other people tell me, oh, you can use Velcro. I can use Velcro, but sometimes we lose the Velcro because we're moving, we're breaking down. Sometimes the Velcros, you can lose them. But these, if you lose them, you're gonna find them. Trust me, you're gonna find them. Okay, look, let me show you. Okay, this, we're gonna leave it like that, but I'm gonna fix it. Look, pretty simple. Just like every other cable that I work with, zip tie it, make sure there's enough slack. Yeah, enough slack. Oh no. Yeah, we're good. Okay, one right here. But don't leave it just like that. Look, there's some slack to it. No, do not do that. Make it tight, pull it down, make it tight. Down here, one more. Okay, there we go. We should be good to go. Oh yes, I turned the battery that way so nobody can see the actual display, just to make it look a little bit nicer. All right. Let's see, cross your fingers. And it didn't turn on. Hold on, let me do some troubleshooting, hold on. I am so sorry. This is to turn it on, to turn this plugs on. My bad, I'm sorry. This is my first time using it, so bear with me. Okay. Moment of truth, here we go. 4, 3, 2. And 1. My apologies. It was on, it's just that our angle, you can't see it. Watch, let me show you. Look at that, it is on. My apologies. All right, let's continue. All right, on your computer, what you wanna do, turn your Bluetooth on, make sure it is on, which would be right here. You see, can you see it through there? Mm-hmm. Okay, turn it on. I have it, sorry, I'm sorry, I should erase that. I'm so sorry. Okay, on the speaker, turn the speaker on. Right here is gonna say pair. Come here, get closer. It's gonna say pair. Oh, there you go, it's pairing up. There you go. All right, let's make sure it paired up with the computer. All right, there, it's paired up. We're good to go. Always turn off your Wi-Fi. Please always turn off your Wi-Fi. All right, let's go to Serato, let's turn it on. Let's make sure it connects before I go set up for reception. So when you're doing a wedding, make sure you always set up for ceremony first. That is primary. Why? Because right after ceremony is cocktail. And during cocktail, you can troubleshoot at reception, your audio, something's going on. So that's why it's very important to always take care of ceremony first. Make sure ceremony set up. Then once you're done with ceremony, go where your reception is gonna be. Make sure everything is set up right there. All right, cool, there it opened up. There you go. All right, let's see if it connected. Let's play the first song. Let's see, there you go. Okay. Oh, there we go. We got audio. You don't believe me? Let's turn it off, look. And it's off. All right, now let's try the microphone. All right, and we're paired up. I paired the wireless microphone with the transmitter. Okay, on the transmitter right here, check it out. I never put it at full blast. Why? Because if you put it at full blast, you're gonna be able to hear any minor little discrepancy on the microphone. You're gonna be able to hear it. You hear, you've got signal. So that's why I put it at 3/4 of the volume. That is 100%, that is 3/4, that is half, that is 1/4 right there. So that would be 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock. That's my preference. I'm not telling you that's the way you have to do it. You have to do it like that. No, that is what works for me. I like to deliver quality entertainment. So that's why I'm showing you what I do. All right, microphone check. Woo, yeah. All right, but we need more volume back here. 1, 2, 1, 2. So the volume is gonna be the main volume all the way up over here. Oh, let me show you another great feature right here. This is right here, eliminate the feedback. You just push that and it will eliminate the feedback. What is feedback? Is when you get too close to the mic, to the speaker with the wireless microphone, you get that screech. Nobody wants that, trust me, especially at a ceremony. Oh no, look, oh look. But that's full, almost full volume back there. Not bad.
Not bad at all. That sounds great. Microphone check, 1, 2. Can you give me some volume in the back speaker, please? Microphone check, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. You know what, give me more volume on the transmitter. 1, 2, give it a full blast. All right, microphone check, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. You know what, I say we relocate. I don't like how it sounds.
I say we put the speaker, let's place it over there. What do you think? Give me a few minutes. Let me show you that it is completely wireless. I turned it off. Let me show you. Don't stop it. I want them to see. Don't stop it. Yeah, we're good? All right. Look, literally moving it. Look, it actually worked out because there's not an outlet right here. There's no outlet. Yeah, no outlet. So I would have to run a power cable all the way to the back. A black cord. But like I said, I've tried to minimize my equipment for ceremony. You know, you should check out that video, the hell I went through when I did the ceremony out on the beach. What the hell was I thinking? Okay, now let's check. Make sure it still works.
Microphone check, 1, 2. Microphone check.
Sounds great.
Do you take your lovely wife? Yes, I do. You see, sounds great. Come here.
We also purchased this mic stand through Guitar Center. It was like, how much was it? $30, $35? Yeah. It was like $35? Yeah, it was like $35. Look, perfect for the efficient. Ladies and gentlemen, oh, sounds great. Sounds good, right? Sounds good, yeah? So, that is how I do my wireless setup. All right, we're done with ceremony. Perfect, it couldn't be any more perfect. But now I gotta move the X thumb, the speaker, out to cocktail. Let's do that right now. It's out of the way. When people are walking through, they can trip over the tripod. So now we're gonna move on to their cocktail playlist. Remember, like I've always said, request for a playlist. It makes your job 1,000 times much more easier on you. Believe me.